Now, it doesn't matter if it's a run capacitor or a start capacitor. We're just going to show you how to test it. And if it's failing or going to fail, or if you have a problem with your pump, it's a good thing to test. So I'll link these, I'll link some testers on the bottom. This one's a really good one, but it's a little bit more money. But if you use it enough times, yeah, it's great to have, I'm telling you. You'd be surprised how many times you use it. Once you get the capacitor off, I'm just showing you how to test it. I'm not showing you how to take it out or where it is and stuff like this. Usually it's on top of the pump or in back of the pump. So we take that out, we're gonna test it. Okay, so when you first take it out, now it could hold a charge up to about 5 minutes. So what you're gonna do, as soon as you get it out, you're gonna take a screwdriver and you're just gonna put it across the leads. Don't worry, it's not gonna spark or nothing. So what that does, it just pops the charge off. Okay, so when you touch it, if you touch it the right way, you can get this little zap out of it. So just put it across so we lose that charge, okay? So we're good to go. So what you're gonna do is, we're gonna test this one first. So it doesn't matter what leads going where, black, red, whatever. Okay, so for this particular one, we just hold it down and it shows open. Now, if it says open or closed, it's a bad capacitor. Now it should have a number in it, and then we can compare the number here. So here it's a 5 UF. So if we pushed it and we had a 1, we know it's failing, okay? Now you wouldn't test it otherwise if you knew there was already a problem. So more than likely it's gonna have an open or closed or like a 1. Okay, maybe your pump's not turning on or not heating. And so this one here is a dead one. Okay, this one here, visually, this type here, you can kind of see, this is a brand new one, this is an old one. You see the difference. You get this oil that's inside there. I don't know exactly what's in it, but it's almost like an oil. So a lot of times you'll see these the ring around here, this ring, you'll see it pop right off. And that's what's tripping. This ring pops off, and then it just leans itself against the two leads and just pops the breaker. So if you see that, you have to replace it or any type of oil. Not a good indication. It's not very often you see it, but where it sits in the, you know, on top of the pump or on the side of the pump or in the back, on the outside, before you even open it up, you'll see some kind of oil coming out. If you touch it and it's like really oily, if you find out that your pump's tripping a breaker, do these tests. If you visually see it, replace it, because you don't really have to test it. You know it's going to fail or it has failed. Okay, so we're going to test this one. I know this one here is still good, but so this type has a range. So this, go back to this one. This one here has one, just 5 UF. Some of them will have a range between 5 and 25. That's, it could run. So that one's at 55. So you look on here, and it says 125. So we know it's, like this one's a brand new one too. So you can try it. I think it's a dead one. I'll test this one here. So I know this one's 145, but it's visually, you'd know it's gonna fail soon. So this one's 145 on the side. There's a range, 125 to 145. So we're good, like 136. So, but I would, anything visually, if you see that the ring popped off or any oil or anything like that, change the capacitor, and all information's right on it. I'll link on the bottom this capacitor tester here. Now, if this video helped you out, subscribe to us. There's videos out coming out all the time. Maybe something else will help you out. Okay, and we'll see you in the next one.